Okay guys, welcome back to our second video tutorial on the kinetics topic. In this video tutorial we're going to talk about rate laws, and you can see the expression for the rate law there, and hopefully you instantly recognize this guy. We talked about this expression in the previous video tutorial. This is basically the rate of change in the concentration of A. Now A might be some reactant, kind of doesn't matter what it is. You can see that there's a negative sign here, so I'm clearly talking about a reactant. If there's a negative sign there, this is something that's getting used up in the reaction. But there's another way that we can express this, and this is what we call the rate law, and it looks like this guy in the blue box. So, and it has the general form of K, where K is some constant, multiplied by the concentration of that reactant to the power of n. And I'm going to start out by talking about what n is. N is the reaction order. It's the degree to which the rate of the reaction depends on the concentration of each reactant. We'll explore this with a few examples. Really important point, n is not related to the stoichiometric coefficients in the balanced chemical equation. This is something you've got to determine by experiment. Okay, so please don't ever think that this number here comes from some of those coefficients in your balanced equation. N can be zero, it can be an integer, it can even be a fractional value, but we'll just limit our conversation to reactions where N is zero, one, or two. And we say that this is zero order, first order, or second order. There's also this constant here, yeah? It's the rate constant. Of course, we're talking about kinetics, the rates of chemical reactions, and all different chemical reactions have unique kinetics. And what sort of, if you like, in some ways might be considered the fingerprint of those kinetics for a particular reaction can be described by a combination of the rate constant and the order of the reaction. So K's characteristic of the reaction, as I say, and the reaction conditions, so temperature, pressure, solvent, so you manipulate those parameters, then you're actually going to change the value of K. And something else which is kind of odd with K is that its units vary depending on the order of the reaction. And so we'll explore that as we go through a few examples. The first of which is first order, and I'll start by talking about first order. In some ways, it's one of the more simple orders to discuss, and we'll see why on this slide here. The reaction rate is directly proportional to the concentration of one of the reactants. Okay, so if we look at this expression here, you can see that the order n has the value of 1. Well, anything to the power of 1 is just itself. So the rate order is actually really just boiled down, focused on that equation there. It's just the rate constant multiplied by the concentration. Let's think about what this means. Okay, so as the reaction proceeds, the concentration of A is decreasing because you're kind of using it up as you go, right? So if the rate of the reaction is K multiplied by A, and A is decreasing, then the rate of the reaction is decreasing kind of as you go along, which is an intuitive sort of thing to think. What's more, because it's first order, if the concentration of A is doubled, then the rate of the reaction exactly doubles. If the concentration of A is increased 10 times, then the rate increases 10 times. Okay, this is not true for all reactions, even though that might be what you intuitively think. It's only true for what we call first order reactions. The units for K, keep a close eye on this, guys, and I'm going to change colors to this kind of lurid orange just to really sort of bring that on the slide. The units for K are seconds to the minus one. Okay, when we're talking about time in kinetics, we should, where possible, use SI units, and the SI units for time are seconds. In this case, the units for K are seconds to the minus one. Second order reaction. So in this case, the reaction rate is directly proportional to the square of the concentration. In other words, N is equal to 2. Still going with this lurid orange color. What does this mean? How's this different to first order? Well, let's think about that. If the reaction, if sorry, if the concentration of A doubles, then the rate of the reaction is actually going to increase by a factor of four. Yeah, does that make sense? So if we have one squared, that's just one. If we have two squared, that equals four. Yeah, you quadruple the rate as you double the concentration. Once again, and I'll sort of flick around my colors because it's a kind of zany thing to do. Wow, hang on a sec. Suddenly the units for K have changed. Something I'd argue we don't see this very often in chemistry. Normally you've got, some parameter, it's always got the same units. K, the rate constant in kinetics, is a bit different. It actually, the units can change. And so you can see here for a second order reaction, the units for K are actually now liters per mole per second. I'll put it to you that this could also be written like this: molarity to the minus one seconds to the minus one. Yeah? Yeah, this is kind of like inverse molarity, isn't it? And so don't be surprised, you will see this around the place, this kind of terminology. And we'll finish just by talking about a zero order reaction. Zero order reactions actually completely independent of concentration. If we look at it in this first expression here, we can see that this is like a zero order, then n equals zero. Yeah, n equals zero. Well, anything to the power of zero is just one. It doesn't matter what the concentration is. If it's a zero order reaction, that concentration to the power of zero is just going to be one. So, sort of think of, just ignore that one. If you're trying to write out the rate of a reaction for a zero order kinetics, it's just K, completely independent of the concentration. In other words, this reaction just goes at the same rate the whole time, no matter what your starting concentration was. What about the units for K? I'll flick back to a sort of a nice blue. Units for K are sort of similar to second order, although hang on, this is flipped around now. It's now moles per second. They're not moles to the minus one per second, but moles per second. So the rate of this reaction doesn't vary with time. So the graph of a reactant as a function of time would be straight line. So if this is time and this is the concentration, yep. As time goes on, it's just straight line. It doesn't change. If we were talking about the products, it'd kind of be the other way around. Yeah, as time goes on, you get some product, let's just call it B. Yep. It starts at zero and then just shoots up. It's so linearly like that. Eventually, you run out of reactants. The reaction just stops. Whoops, hang on a sec. The reaction, the concentration, it just stopped like that. Okay. Anyway, guys, that's the order with respect to the rate laws. So we'll talk about some of our integrated rate laws in the next video tutorial.